Namaste everyone, welcome all of you to the Distance Learning Center, the portal of West Montessori Elementary School. Welcome year 6. In the previous video, I started a topic rational and irrational numbers there. There we studied the concept about rational and irrational number. What are rational numbers? What are irrational numbers? Along with the decimals. The decimals that terminate, the decimals that do not terminate but reoccur, and the decimals that is non-recurring and non-terminating. Okay, now let me repeat the fact again. Now decimal that terminates 1.45, this is terminating. Another one is the decimal that is non-terminating but recurring. Non-terminating, look here, I have taken two digits are recurring. It may be 4.3333. Look, the 3 is recurring. Okay, and the third decimal is, it's non-terminating but non-recurring. Let me do 1.414213. Here, the number after 4 there is 1 and after 4 there is 2. Again, it is 1 and 3. That means it is non-terminating and non-recurring. Now, 3 sets of decimals. 1, 2, 3. These two are rational and these are irrational. Now here in the and today here with some workout examples identifying rational or irrational number. Look here, the first one is decimal itself, 1.333. That means the first we have to identify that the decimal is non-terminating, it is not ending. If not ending, then we have to identify whether a digit or a group of digits are recurring or not. See, recurring. That means it is a rational number. 2. Every whole numbers are rational numbers. Every integers are rational numbers. 4/5. For this we have to divide in rough. Okay. Now if we use a rough, that means now let's divide 4/5. That means 5 divided by 4. It's not divisible. That's why point. Now it becomes 40. 5. 8s are 40. Now the remainder is 0. That means it's 0.8. 0.8 means it is terminating. All the terminating decimals are rational number. So you can follow the same with this one. And root 9. Root 9 means we have studied. Root 9 is equivalent to root 3 into 3. That means 3. 3 is a whole number. It is a rational number. In case of root 2, we have to know the root value of root 2. Here I have written the value of root 2. Actually, this is root 2. That means root 2. 1.414213. That means the number is non-terminating. Doesn't end. And is non-recurring. Look, the same digits are not recurring. Here if it's 4-1, there is 4-2. Now again it is 1-3. The numbers, digits are non-recurring. That means root 2 is irrational number. Okay, now let's move to the second question. That is, we have to write the 3 fractions that have denominator 3. Okay, let me do it. 3 fractions with denominator 3. 4/3. 1/3. 7/3. Okay, now express them in decimals. That means we have to divide. I'm going to do 1. Okay. 4 you divided by 3, 3 once 3, that means the remainder is 1. Now if we have to divide 1, since 1 is not divisible by 3, let's introduce a point so that we can write here 0. Now 3, 3 is a 9. That means again decimal 1. Again, if we follow the process, it will be 10 and that there is the remainder of 1. And that means it will be 1.333 and goes on. Okay, let's move to the again to the third fractions. It is 7 divided by 3. Look, 3 to the 6. Again, the remainder is 1. When into this decimal, make it 10. Then again, 3 threes are 9. Again, the remainder is 1. Follow the same process. It will be 2.333 goes on. Look at the conclusion. That means 4 by 3 will be equals to 1.333 goes on. 7 by 3 will be equals to 2.3333 goes on. Similarly, 1 by 3, you can do it this in rough, I haven't done here. It will be 0.33333 and goes on. Let's look at the decimal now. What kind of decimals are they? They are non-terminating, doesn't end, goes on, but they are recurring. 3 is repeating every time, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, in all cases. That means these decimals, they are non-terminating but recurring. That means what conclusion can we write is, the decimals are non-terminating but recurring decimals. That is, these numbers are decimal. Sorry, these numbers are rational number. Now the final conclusion will be, any integers when divided by 3, any integers when divided by 3 will be a rational number. Why? Because the decimal will be recurring but non-terminating decimal. I hope the video was really helpful for the problems in your worksheets that covers the area of rational and irrational numbers. Okay, stay tuned to the Distance Learning Center of West Montessori Elementary School. Till we meet again, stay safe. Bye-bye. Have a good time ahead.